Hey everyone, this is Ryan from MultiUnity.com, and in this video I'll be doing an audio comparison of the Blue Yeti here to the Zoom H2 here, as you can see in the video. Now, currently in the frame you can see the Yeti itself, you can see part of me, and if you're wondering why I'm holding this tablet here, the Nexus 7, recently I got the on-the-go cable, the micro USB on-the-go cable for the Nexus 7, because there's an app on the Google Play Store that enables you to use your Android devices with your Canon DSLR. So I'm recording this video with my Canon 60D hooked up via the USB cable through the on-the-go adapter here, as we can see. So the Nexus 7 here is actually displaying what you're seeing. So very cool, and I just thought I'd point that out in case anyone's wondering. So but more importantly, the main reason or main subject of this video is to get an audio comparison from the Blue Yeti and the Zoom H2 portable handy recorder. Now, the two are you know, completely different use devices. The Blue Yeti is made intentionally for USB studio condenser microphone usage, so it's not really portable. As you can see here, it's a big unit. The Zoom H2, on the other hand here, is a very, very portable unit. It does work externally via with batteries and an SD card, so you don't need to have this hooked up to a computer through a USB port to have this running. However, you can still use the H2 without any battery and SD card as a USB microphone like the Yeti here. So, but for this video, and you know, to compare the audio differences, the Blue Yeti is going to be hooked up like it is now via USB, and this portion you're actually listening to and you've been listening to is actually being recorded with the Blue Yeti. The H2 here, as you can see, it's not on. And we're going to be doing a side-by-side comparison of the audio differences between the H2 and the Yeti. But this first portion is being recorded with the Blue Yeti. So, so what I'm going to do here is just put the H2 and the Yeti side-by-side and say a few clips, say a few things, and then you guys, I'll play it back through the video. First the Blue Yeti clip and then the Zoom H2 clip. And so in 1, 2, 3 we're gonna get started. So 1, 2, 3. Alright, so we are now doing a side-by-side audio comparison here with the Zoom H2 and the Blue Yeti. So they're both recording as I'm speaking right now. And what I'm gonna do so that you guys can get a good idea of these two in terms of audio quality, so I'm going to play back the same clip, but the portion you're listening to right now is from the Blue Yeti, and I'm going to play it back after this clip is over, and with the Zoom H2's audio. So in 1, 2, 3, you're going to listen to the Zoom H2's audio of the same clip. 1, 2, 3. All right, so we are now doing a side-by-side audio comparison here with the Zoom H2 and the Blue Yeti. So they're both recording as I'm speaking right now. And what I'm gonna do so that you guys can get a good idea of these two in terms of audio quality, is I'm gonna play back the same clip, but the portion you're listening to right now is from the Blue Yeti, and I'm going to play it back after this clip is over, and with the Zoom H2's audio. So in 1, 2, 3, you're gonna listen to the Zoom H2's audio of the same clip. 1, 2, 3. All right, so this is gonna be another audio test. 1, 2, 3, testing, testing, testing. This is an audio test between the Zoom H2 and the Blue Yeti. All right, so this is gonna be another audio test. 1, 2, 3, testing, testing, testing. This is an audio test between the Zoom H2 and the Blue Yeti. Alright, so hopefully you guys found this video helpful. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment down below. and I'll try to answer it as soon as possible. If you have any questions on the two microphones and their settings and etc., you can also leave a comment and I'll try to get back to you soon. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. I'll have links to the product pages of these two microphones down in the description as well, in case you like to purchase one of them after watching this audio demonstration. So that's about it. Be sure to follow me on Twitter at ATURyan, and I'll see you guys all in the next one. All right, so hopefully you guys found this video helpful. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment down below, and I'll try to answer it as soon as possible. If you have any questions on the two microphones and their settings and etc., you can also leave a comment, and I'll try to get back to you soon. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. I'll have links to the product pages of these two microphones down in the description as well, in case you like to purchase one of them after watching this audio demonstration. So that's about it. Be sure to follow me on Twitter at ATURyan, and I'll see you guys all in the next one.